We did a survey from 100 people, including adults and students. Here's our results. In the questionnaire, we designed four questions. For the first question of the average sleeping hours, the results show that 9% of the people sleep for only 4 to 5 hours, which is considered as lack of sleeping. In the medium level of 6 to 7 hours of sleeping, there are totally 73% of people. As for more than 8 hours of sleeping, there are only 18% of the people, and 10 hours only has 1. We can indicate from the data that people cannot get enough sleep now, and the average sleeping time is only 6.66 hours. So under this situation, our goal is to provide some ways that will help people feel energetic, although the sleeping time is not enough. Sounds interesting. In the second question, asking whether people want to stay up late or get up early for their unfinished work, the result is still very shocking for us. Only 12% of the people choose to get up early. But is that the most efficient way of doing? There are still a lot of things to be considered. For the question that what methods do you use to help you get to sleep, the results are shown. On the left, there are the choices that we offer. 40 people have listened to music, 22 have read books, and 16 have drunk milk. We also get some other answers, which are shown on the right. For example, wear blinder, watch videos, memorize vocabularies, do exercise, and traditionally, counting.
As for the last question of the factors that will affect sleeping, the main factor is the events that will happen in the following day, which has influenced 51% of the people. The second big factor is the cell phones that affect 30% of people, followed by factors that affect 23% of people of environmental factors like roommates or mosquitoes. An objective factor is too much work to finish, which 13% of people are influenced. Finally, the mental and physical factors of too much pressure or getting sick. Based on the data we collected, we have several questions to be solved. How to help people although they cannot get enough sleep? Is staying up late for working really better than getting up early? Are the methods that people use to help sleep efficient? What are the main factors that will influence sleeping?
Now let's take a look at an expert's opinion. Here we have Nick Littlehales, a famous sleeping instructor who had studied sleep for over 30 years. In his book, Sleep, he proposed the R90 sleeping method.
It is the best time to be in a sleeping condition at midnight. In his opinion, he also recommended to sleep at 1:30 or 3 a.m. if you cannot finish your work in time.
He also divided the sleeping process into four stages. The first stage, snoring, requires no rapid eye movement. The second stage, light sleep, requires subtle eye movement. During the third stage, your body secretes HGH, a growth hormone. This stage is best able to account for 20% of the whole sleeping process. People begin dreaming during the fourth stage. Also, you should make sure this stage takes up 20% of the whole sleeping process.
The author also offers several tips for completely implementing the R90 method. First, you should give yourself 30 to 45 minutes relaxing time without doing violent activities before sleep. Second, make your wake-up time fixed. You can use 3-to-1 counting technique to wake you up. Third, sleep for 30 or 90 minutes if you want to take a nap. Finally, remember to evaluate your sleeping in unit of weeks, not days.